Hello viewers, welcome to Wisdom Jobs. This is Swati, your English instructor for English grammar. So let us see what are we going to learn today. But before going into the topic, please do like and subscribe our channel Wisdom Jobs in YouTube. And also if you have any queries or any doubts regarding any new topics, then please do drop a comment at our comment box. So let us see what are we going to learn today. So today we are going to learn about forms of adjective. Basically, you might have also seen our previous video regarding parts of speech, where we have described 8 parts of speech in which adjective is also one among them. So let us see the forms of adjective and how the forms of adjectives are formed while making the use of words. So basically, adjectives are divided into 3 categories: positive degree, comparative degree and superlative degree. So basically, adjectives are divided into 3 forms, or popularly known as 3 degrees. So what are those 3 forms of adjective? Positive degree, comparative degree and superlative degree. So let us see the 3 forms of degrees and how do they affect the formation of words or sentences and how they are popularly used in the English grammar. So let us see what is positive degree and the other forms of adjectives. So let us go through what is positive degree. Positive degree, first of all, do not have any change, like big, loud, long, strong, etc. These are the various examples of adjectives which we popularly use in the formation of sentences. So in positive degree, we only use these same words such as big, loud, long and strong. There is no changes, especially in the degree. And comparative degree. So what is a comparative degree? In comparative degree, words are ended with the joining of er. We end the word by joining er at the last. For example, bigger, where er, er is joined, stronger, where again er is joined, louder, where again er is joined, and longer, where again er is joined. These are the 4 examples of comparative degree. Now let us see the example of superlative degree. Words end in est. Just like comparative degree, here in superlative degree, we end words by adding est. By adding est at the end, the words are known to be in superlative degree. For example, biggest, where est is added, loudest, where est is added, strongest, where est is added, longest, where again est is added. So now let us know where are these rules especially applicable. Specifically, these rules, er, est and the no change rule, these rules are especially applicable only where the words contain of 2 syllables. Where the words contain only 2 syllables, there only we use these kind of rules. So for the words which contain 3 or more syllables, what do we use there? So there we follow the following rules applied. Examples in positive. So some words such as understandable, comfortable, etc. These kind of words have 3 or more kind of syllables inside them. So there, first in positive degree, there would be no change. But in comparative degree, we use more. Just like we add here er and est in the other degree rule, we add here more. And in superlative degree, we add most. Like, for example, beautiful, more beautiful, and most beautiful. So these kind of rules are applicable only where 3 or more syllables are contained in a word. So this is a kind of another rule. So especially while forming a sentences or while forming any new words, you have to clearly remember these 3 categories: positive, comparative and superlative. Positive, comparative and superlative. Where 3 categories are divided and according to the syllables contained in a word, the rules change. So please do remember how to use these words. So if you have liked our video, regarding the comparison of adjectives and the forms of adjectives, then please do like and subscribe our channel Wisdom Jobs, and also please do share our videos. And if you have any doubts regarding this topic, or do you want to uncover any new topic, then please do comment in our comment box. Thank you.